Hi, I'm Father Jim Martin, editor-at-large at America Media and author of Learning to Pray, A Guide for Everyone, published by Harper One and available everywhere books are sold. When I was a boy, the only way I knew how to pray was to ask God for things. Give me this, give me that. And that's okay. Nothing wrong with petitionary prayer at all. But until I entered the Jesuits at age 27, I thought that this was the only way to pray. Far from it. In my book, Learning to Pray, I talk about many ways to pray. Let's look at five of the most popular. First is Ignatian contemplation. This tradition was popularized by St. Ignatius Loyola, the founder of the Jesuits, and it uses your imagination to place yourself in a scripture scene. Initially, that struck me as strange, until my first spiritual director reminded me that your imagination is a gift from God and just another way for God to encounter you. In Ignatian contemplation, you picture yourself with as much detail as you can muster in a scene from the Bible. Say, the storm at sea. You ask yourself, what do I see? What do I hear, feel, taste, smell? Often what comes up is highly personal and makes the story your own. Second, Lectio Divina. Latin for sacred reading, Lectio usually means praying with a text from the Bible, although it could also be with a spiritual master. I like to use four questions suggested by Daniel J. Harrington, the New Testament scholar. What does the text say? What does the text say to me? What do I want to say to God about this text? And what difference will this text make in my life? A third type of prayer is the examine, or examination of conscience. It's a popular practice in Jesuit circles and is a review of the day to help you see where God has been active. In general, it's easier to see God in the past than it is in the present, and the examine is a daily look back. You start by placing yourself in the presence of God, then recall things that you're grateful for, and then move through the day, seeing where you noticed God. You also ask for forgiveness for what you've done wrong, and then the grace to see God in the next day. The examine really helps you to notice. Fourth, centering prayer is a kind of content-free prayer, which relies less on images and words and more on encountering God within you wordlessly. It's a simple prayer where you use a prayer word like God or Jesus or love to ground and center you. Sometimes people critique centering prayer, forgetting that this idea has a long history. After all, St. Paul says that we are temples of the Holy Spirit and that God dwells within us. Mainly, centering prayer is a technique that helps people encounter the presence of God. Finally, what I call in my book, nature prayer, is any prayer where you use nature to help you encounter God in creation. Whether it's seeing a part of nature as an image of God, allowing nature to calm you, enjoying nature as God's creation, letting nature teach you about God, or simply reverencing nature, you can pray in nature. In this way, you can live out what the psalmist said. When I look at the heavens, the work of your fingers, the moon and the stars that you have established, what are human beings that you are mindful of them, mortals that you care for them? There are numerous ways to pray on your own, many of which I speak about in my book, but there's no one right way to pray. Whatever way enables you to encounter God is the right way for you. The key is learning to pray, starting out, being consistent, and trusting that God wants to encounter you there. Learning to Pray, A Guide for Everyone, is published by Harper One and available everywhere books are sold.